Welcome to the launch of UK Disability History Month. We've just done a great big event in Parliament this morning, so some of us are a bit worn out. Well, we did launched a pack for the history of people with learning difficulties, which Richard wrote with the UK. And now we've got our proper launch, which is disability and language. And we've got really interesting people to speak. And the first person who's going to do some of her poems is Maresa MacKeith on my right, who I've known many years, but I'm going to read about her very briefly. She's a writer, educator and observer, and she has a collection of poetry called Taking the Time, which came out in 2011. And she now is a founding member of Quiet Riot, which is a radical group of people with no speech. And she's going to share some of her poems with us. Thank you.
Check this mic is on. Is it okay? Everyone can hear you all right. No, not really.
It's not on.
Can we get the mic up a little bit? Is that better?
Yes.
Yeah. Lily, I can't hear you.
Okay. Is that better?
Yes.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Great.
Oh.
Hi. I am Maresa. A writer. Educator. And observer of the world. Here are my poems. What future? My friend has people around him to assist. He thinks and he writes. They attend places of learning, the pleasure of the park. They get his thoughts down on paper, together. The world is better off for his thinking. Future plans tell him that soon no one will be there. He will sit alone, frightened, as there is no one there. He can't go to study. He can't tell the world his thoughts, as there is no one there. We are poorer without his thinking. There are many different ways of taking life away. We can extinguish breath or forcibly disconnect. So, no more conversations, no more walks in the park. There are many different ways of taking life away. His life. Well, so what? He is just too expensive, after all.
Sorry, can somebody please ask everybody out there to be quiet, because it's quite disturbing. Thank you very much. There should only be one person out there.
That poem was about a friend of mine who is at risk of his assistance being taken away. Now,
do words have meaning? Mute, dumb, falling behind. I have to think how we go forward. It is our fusion that makes us whole. It is our fusion that makes us whole. Our fusion of thought and connection. You are part of me. I am part of you. You cannot exist without me. I cannot exist without you. Life is to be lived in all its mess and fragility. I embrace your fragility. I impact. Blood drips off the bodies murdered by the terrified. Blood drips off the bodies murdered by the terrified. Mental age, special needs, wheelchair bound, helpless. Our special need for home, connection and purpose. Our vehicle that takes us to the world. Our excitement in exploration at our own pace. It is our fusion that makes us whole. Drain on resources, burden, respite care. Respite from what? The closeness of touch or the tyranny of loneliness? It is our fusion that makes us whole.
And one.
Touch. In 1913, Helen Keller considered it a priceless gift and a deep responsibility to think, and a time for loud-voiced, open speech and fearless thinking, against individualism, conquest and exploitation. In quiet riot, this is what we do, we think. And through the conduit of others, we voice that thinking. Nearly a century later, Paul Thomas wrote, "My mind does excel. My mind instructs me to move. My limbs often will not comply." We all can be seen as mute and helpless, but we know what we can give, the power of connection. The anti-rights, dialogues are your vehicle. Connecting is your power. We connect, like Helen Keller, through our hands and a touch. We know that power, and through that power, we know we can survive on our own. We can't survive on our own, as none of us can. In 1916, Helen Keller was in the fight to change things. She said of herself, "I may be a dreamer, but dreamers are necessary to make facts." We must ally ourselves to and act with the millions of invisible bodies who enable us to survive, the countless souls who live and die unrecognised. We know we are connected.
Thank you for listening. I have books for sale. Including an anthology of work by writers who who communicates. Using alternative methods of communication.
Some of Maresa's poems are in the pack that you've got in front of you, but please buy the book that's outside if you'd like to. Thank you.